Srila Sarasvati Thakur tells us, do not give up your service in spite of all danger, all criticism, or all discomforts, because they will come. It's not that we think that because I'm serving Krishna, everything's going to go my way. Everyone's going to love me, and everyone's going to praise me, and everything's going to be comfortable because I'm serving Krishna. Well, if that's what you think, then read Bhagavad Gita. Arjuna, read Srimad Bhagavatam, the Pandavas, Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj, Ambarish Maharaj, Gajendra, Ranti Dev, Krishna leaving Vrindavan, and the Gopas and the Gopis. For great souls, obstacles. Advaitacharya told us to Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya confirmed it. Obstacles on the path of devotion are the friends of a devotee, because they help us to really keep Krishna in the center and take shelter and understand what really matters. So great souls are put through difficult situations to show us how to be great. And for us, obstacles, they are opportunities that if we just respond properly, they make us great devotees. We should never give up. Srila Prabhupada personified that. His Gurudev, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, his first instruction and his last instruction was to take the message of Lord Chaitanya to the English-speaking world. The opportunity really didn't come until he was 70 years old on the Jaladuta. And he got two heart attacks and seasickness. And 38 days later, landed in New York. And after Butler, Pennsylvania, he was living in the Bowery. He had no money. He had nobody helping him. Even the people in India thought it was impossible, so they didn't want to waste their money or time or energy helping him. He had a stroke. He had people coming to kill him. But he didn't give up. This instruction of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur, he took it so seriously. In spite of danger, criticism, or discomforts, not to give up. And even in this world, a person is great when they never give up. Whether they're athletes, or politicians, or businessmen, or philanthropists, people who are great that people remember on any level of society are people who, despite all difficulties, obstacles, and impossible situations, they didn't give up. And if people could do that for political power, for money, for helping people in a philanthropic way, how much a devotee should be willing to do that? To show their love for Krishna and to be an instrument of Krishna's compassion for people we love in this world, who should be everyone. Srila Saraswati Thakur tells, do not be disappointed because things are not going to always go your way. He would send his devotees out to give lectures. There are instances where they came and they said only two or three people came to our lecture. And Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, oh, that's wonderful. Two or three people. He said, you are speaking the message of Chaitanya Dev for Krishna's satisfaction. And you're making it available to the world. If no one comes, you should be fully enthusiastic and grateful and empowered to preach to the four walls. And again, Srila Prabhupada took this instruction so seriously. If you read his diary, he's coming from Vrindavan. He's a Paramhamsa. He's an Acharya. He's come to to fulfill the prophecy of Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda. He's come to fulfill the prophecy of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He's come to fulfill the mission of Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur to spread all over the world. And he writes in his diary, I went to an apartment in Manhattan and four people came. And they seemed to like the chanting. I can understand that Haridas Thakur's and Lord Nityananda's prediction will take place, that everyone will be chanting the holy names. He was not disappointed. Four people came, and they just liked the chanting. And the first major program that the devotees had for him when they were just in 26 Second Avenue, they rented an auditorium, first time ever, the first program beyond a tiny little storefront on the Lower East Side. Was a big place, and hardly the first row was filled with people. Everything else was empty. The devotees were totally disappointed, and Prabhupada got up on the stage and was preaching as if there were thousands of people with so much enthusiasm. The devotees, they begged forgiveness. We're sorry that nobody came. He said, nobody came? You didn't see? Narada Muni was there. Lord Brahma was there. Now, what that means could be one of two things, or both. Could mean that Narada Muni and Brahma were physically there. We just didn't see him. The Prabhupada did. But it definitely also means that Krishna and all the great acharyas of our parampara are accepting whatever we sincerely offer. Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur said, if no one comes, speak this message to the four walls, and Narada Muni, Brahma, Krishna, your guru, everyone will be there hearing. That's what it's about. Prabhupada was never disappointed. The thing that discouraged him the most was when there was fighting, quarreling among his followers. But even then, he was never disappointed. If thousands of people came, he said this Krishna consciousness movement is for everyone, just chanting, dancing, and feasting. If no one came, he said that in Tiffany's jewelry store, because they're selling such precious jewels, not so many people come. But in the general stores to get glass jewelry, so many people are coming. So whatever the situation, he was enthusiastic, never disappointed.
You are listening to Radhanath Swami on thesacredconnect.com.